Hey, Brett McFall here, and I'm letting you go behind the scenes again for step three of a seven-part system here for creating your own expert empire, which means if you're in a coaching niche, consulting niche, or you want to create your own information product business, then the things I'm teaching here are what I've learned since doing this, since I started back in 2002. So this is the stuff that I would teach my friends, teach my family. This is the inside story, and these folks got the full deal, and now for the first time you're getting access to that as well. So the thing to remember in this one is, as you hear me teach this, it's all about, you know, being the one thing that's important in your customer's life. It's like, what is your unique selling proposition? And working that out changes the rules, okay? So listen now as I show you step three of how to create your own expert empire. Enjoy.
Step three is, after that, you create your unique solution. Your unique solution. Not just any solution, a solution which nobody else offers. Just like I did with Warp Speed, I thought, there's a lot of people teaching internet marketing, how can I be unique? Often called a USP, a unique selling proposition. If you're offering what other people are offering, you've got a problem. You're going to compete on price if you're offering everybody else's offering, all right? Whatever anyone else is doing, be and do the opposite. So you find out what the competition's doing, and you make a concerted effort to do the exact opposite. If they're offering long training, you're going to offer short training. If theirs is too detailed, too sophisticated, yours is super simple. Go to the opposite end of the scale, because this creates a very clear marketing message later on as well. We can very clearly say, here's why ours is different to XYZ. And here's a bit of truth for you. In the end, it's all just going to be a marketing war about who sells it the best. So although you're going to become quite passionate about your product you're going to create, in the end, it's just going to come down to who markets it the best. When I told you about my Warp Speed program, I said it was good. Was it the best? I'm not sure it was. But I was the best at marketing it. I was the best at what? Marketing it. Connecting with people. And it's all going to come down to who can market the best. Who can have people, have more people say yes than say no. When they come to your website, they come to your training, who's going to be the best at getting people to say yes rather than say no? That's what it's going to come down to. Because people buy a concept from you. They don't buy the actual program. They buy the impression, the concept of the program. Once they get into the program, they get to see what it's really like. But at the moment, they're buying an idea. When all you folks joined me in this program, you were buying a concept. Yes or yes? You hadn't experienced it yet. I hadn't delivered it yet. You were buying the idea of it. And whoever conveys the idea the better way wins. It's got to be a good product. I'm not saying that. It's got to be a good product and possibly a great product. But it all comes down to the marketing in the end. If you connect the best with the audience, you win. If you connect the best, I'm going to show you how to connect, don't worry. You win. It's not about the product. Product's got to be good. Got to solve the problems. Yes, that's how we keep the money. It's not how we get the money. A good product is how we keep the money, not how we get the money. The marketing gets the money. And we create powerful marketing by knowing what our audience wants and by connecting. Like right now, I'm connecting with you. Yes or yes? I'm looking you each in the eye and we're asking questions and you're writing stuff down. You're nodding. This is connection now, right? This is powerful. And your goal will be able to do that on a website, on a webinar, or live in person. Because you want just not mind share, because a lot of people talk about you've got to have mind share. And if you go to advertising agencies and you pay a lot of money to agencies to get your marketing out, they talk a lot about mind share. Got to get a share of your customer's mind. Bullshit. Get their heart. Get their heart. Heart first. Connect. How can you connect? If I asked you to remember some of the best TV commercials you've ever seen, the ones that stick in your mind, I guarantee those ads have hit you in the heart in some way. Made you laugh, made you cry, made you feel something. True or true? Yeah. That's what advertising is all about, connection. And if you have, most of you guys have invested with me at some point you and I connected. So at some point you realize, no, there's something I like about this dude or his program or something about him. I'm liking the whole process. You connected with me. And my goal was to help you connect with me, because I want to connect with you. I can't help you unless you connect with me. Yes or yes? That was my goal, and this is how come I can do what I can do, because I have good stuff to teach you, if not the best in the world. I now create awesome stuff. My job is to get this to you, and I can't get it to you unless you connect with me. Right? Same's going to be for you when it comes to you marketing your stuff. Here's what happens when you connect. When people invest in your product, you get testimonials like this.
Hi Brett, I'd just like to say thank you very much for the course. I've been on the course now for the last 6 months, loving every month, every time it comes through. Can't wait for it to come through. And I've just moved forward every month, and it's been a wonderful experience. Thank you very much.
Have I connected with that gentleman? Yes or yes? Yes. Right, he feels some level of happiness, like yeah. I can't wait for the next month. So I'm showing this as an example, not to make me look good. I'm trying to show you examples of what you need to be able to do.
Yeah, hi, I'm Jeff. I've been at Warpy now for about 10 days, and so far I still don't really know how to build websites. I'm still learning my craft. It's been really exciting. But in that time of not actually knowing how to do it and still learning, I've already made $296, that's US, just in affiliate payments alone. So that's a lot of stuff already paid for that I'm downloading, so that's really cool. Thanks, Brett.
Good or good? And these people are so happy they're wanting to go on camera and talk about it. And that's what you want. Like, when it comes to marketing your program, whatever it's going to be, if you just have testimonial after testimonial like that, people just connect instantly. They go, this guy must be good. This girl must be awesome. Because other people are saying it, not you. Okay? So you're going to be able to create stuff which hits people in the heart so they can happily do the same for you. I really love this person's program. He or she is awesome, and I like it for this reason, that reason. That's what you want. True or true? All right. This is how it's done, folks. Okay. Is your program going to be faster or slower? Is it going to be faster to the end for the consumer, or is it going to be slower? Like my warp speed was like over 12 months. And some people say, well, can I speed it up? Yeah, we can speed it up. We can speed it up if you want to. But it's not designed that way. So mine is based on going fast by taking it slow. I'm going to get you up online by taking it slow, step by step, month by month. But it's faster than doing it yourself, because it'll take you years on your own. But everyone else is giving DVDs and seminars right up front, overwhelming all their customers, and they leave going, well, it was awesome, I just don't know what to do. So I said, let's stretch the process. Make it easier to learn. Is it going to be bigger or smaller? Are you going to have the biggest program there is with more content? Or is it going to be really succinct? Is everything you teach going to be over in 3 minutes? Like you're the 3-minute expert. And you teach your lessons in 3 minutes, you write your small reports, there's going to be short DVDs, short videos. Simple differences like this make a big difference when it comes to marketing and for, absorption by your customers when they get your program. Because there's people that will buy a big program who won't buy the small program and vice versa. So by knowing what your people want, by asking them what they want, they'll tell you, I want it, but I don't want to spend all day reading a book. Sweet, let's give this person shorter lessons. Or there might be a total opposite. It might be a real detailed person. Maybe you're a detailed person. Because there are people who love detail. They're very logical. They want to read every single line and analyze and lots of stuff. There are some people just, give me the basics, man. I'm okay, just give me the basics. You've got to cater for both audiences. Right? Seth Godin calls it being the purple cow. Right? He has a book called Purple Cow. And it's about, really simply, that the fact he's called it purple cow creates an image in your mind. You look at a field, and all these cows are there, and one cow stands out because it's purple. What's the lesson you can learn from that? Just stand out. Yeah, eat chocolate, obviously. Eat chocolate is the lesson, yeah. Stand out in whatever way you can. And most of us are not trained to stand out. Most of us are trained to conform. Toe the company line. Yes? Do it our way. Not anymore. Do it your way. This is the secret to marketing. Standing out. When I am on stage or in a webinar, I say my program is unlike any other in the world. And here's why. Here's why I'm different. And people appreciate the fact that I actually point out how different it is. A quote, remember, from this book is this: if your solution isn't remarkable, then what's the point? if you're going to put all this effort into creating a program, if it isn't going to be remarkable in some way, what's the point of doing it at all? If it's not going to be unique, why do it? There's plenty of people out there who can provide the same boring material. Why do it if yours is going to be the same as that?
Sometimes that still works.
What's that, my friend?
Sometimes that still works.
What still works? Talk to me.
Toyota got a Corolla, Mazda got a 3.
Mitsubishi. Toyota, I'm going to repeat it. Toyota got a Corolla, Mazda got a 3, yep.
Mitsubishi
got an equivalent, yep.
All
cars, all medium-sized cars, all very similar, yeah. Because we've got a what market? Starving market, starving crowd, you can win. They also throw millions of dollars at marketing. Now, I'll tell you something about Toyota, if I can. Who remembers the car called the Camry? And what was it known for?
Wide body.
Wide body. Anybody remember the marketing at all for the wide body Camry? Was she in the ad? Was that happening?
That's the thing, now we'll take a wide body.
Is that right? I forgot that part. But I do remember the tagline. Toyota had the Camry with the wide body, the widest car in the market. What does that tell you? If it's a wide body, what does it tell you? There's more room. So here's the action. So Toyota smashed the market on that. Number one, led the market on the Camry. And the difference in width was 6 centimetres. The wide body was 6 centimetres wider than its competitor. Same car, marketing, difference. Marketing is the purple cow. Am I making sense? So all these car, and the thing that, about car, what we're talking about car manufacturers is they're all selling things with four wheels. And they have to have seat belts and sat navs and stereos and reliability. They have to produce this product that we need to have. So it's very hard to be different, all right? But every now and then there comes out a brand that actually charges way more than a Toyota or a Honda or a Hyundai, yes, or a Mazda. And what are some of their brands?
Lexus.
Which is a Toyota. Okay, so how about that? Anybody heard of Mercedes at all? Anybody heard of Lamborghinis at all? Really, Ferraris, anybody heard of Ferraris at all? Really? They're purple cows in the market, they're purple cows. Because they stand apart, they have differences, and the differences allows them to charge a higher price. And you might say, yeah, but they're better cars. Well, of course they're better, they're different. They're better by being different. True or true? You got it. Whereas most of the car market, they can still make money by being good. Because hungry market. Sell any car you want to China, you're going to become a billionaire. Desperate for cars in China.